Hi guys, welcome back. So in today's video, we're going to talk about how to paraphrase effectively. So if you have been struggling with paraphrasing, then this video is for you. You want to paraphrase without plagiarizing, then this is absolutely for you. So sit back and then let's talk about the easiest way to do this. And you already know I don't come without examples. So I'm going to show you different the ways that you can go about this, and I'm going to give you about three different examples. So sit back and let's get to it. So why are we paraphrasing in the first place? You remember my rule. If you understand the why, then you would understand the how. So why paraphrase? Why is it necessary to paraphrase? When you're paraphrasing, it shows originality. It shows that you have an overview of what you're talking about. You understand the overall ideology of what you are trying to say or the message you're trying to pass across. And in that way, you'll be able to show the relevance. And what do I mean by relevance? That's the relevance of the literature in question that you are paraphrasing. And this would give an overview of the reason for continuance. Remember when I spoke about literature reviews, that when you review several literatures, it makes you come to a conclusion for a reason why you're actually carrying out a particular research. It's also the same thing with paraphrasing. Like if you're able to read an article or a paper very well, and you're able to get what the paper is trying to talk about, is trying to explain, or the message the paper is trying to pass across. So if there is a reason for continuance in that paper, you would be able to pick it out. That's because you have read it and you have understood it. So the main reason for paraphrasing is to show your own knowledge. This is where your own creativity, your art of research and academic writing comes into play. So that is why it is important to paraphrase. So now we understand the why. It is to show our own originality, meaning we want to use our, even though we're using other people's article, we still want to use our own voice. So what are the tips? What are the things we need to know? How to paraphrase? What are the things? How do we paraphrase? So now we understand the why. So let's get to the how. So the easiest way to do it is to read that article more than once. When you read something more than once, trust me, it jumps at you. There are some details, there are some facts that actually jumps at you from that particular article you're reading. And then you highlight the key points. So if to say it's a paragraph in question that you want to paraphrase, read that paragraph like twice. Pick out the key points. What do you understand? Write your own version of events. What do you understand by what you have read in your own words, not in the person's words? In your own words, what do you understand by what you have read? Obviously, some of the words used in the other article might show up in your own what's it called, your version of events that you're writing, which is fine. So now write it in your own words and then compare it to the original source. So if you're able to compare it to the original source, how close to it does it look? And are you able to write in detail? Are you able to explain what you actually read in your own words, not just copying and pasting? So if you're able to do that, write in your, read something and then put it in your own way, the way you understood it, and then now cite that particular article. That way you have paraphrased effectively without plagiarizing. The whole point is you have cited your source from where you got that fact that you're paraphrasing, not just copy and paste, and then not even acknowledging the source of the article itself. So if you can follow these steps, or if you can apply this method to any paragraph, any word, any sentence, anything you want to paraphrase, if you can apply these steps to it, trust me, it would be way easier. And these are some few tips that I think you can also implement. If you try using some of these tips, I think it would really help. So now, when you see a particular paragraph or a particular sentence that you want to paraphrase, if the sentence starts a particular way, let's say according to WHO, try starting from a different point. Instead of saying according to WHO, Why not start with maybe what that article was actually trying to say? Maybe according to WHO, 50% of people would achieve wealth. So why not start with 50% of people would achieve wealth based on a study conducted by the WHO? But that doesn't mean that for everything you now want to write, you now have to write in reverse order or like passive, active passive kind of way. That's not what I'm saying. Every time, like that's not it. But I'm just saying, instead of starting with exactly how it was started in that paragraph, start your own way. Pick your own point that jumps at you. Remember how to do it. Pick your own point that jumps at you. Use synonyms. Replace words with synonyms. But that does not now mean that you will see a sentence like "Ade wants to sleep." And then the next thing you just say, "Ade wants to go to bed," as in it's too direct. Use synonyms, like use certain synonyms to change some few words, not just replacing with synonyms, but still using the same structure that the writer did. That's not paraphrasing. That's still sort of plagiarizing. And then restructure your sentences. That this is where the active passive. If the source you're reading is actually written in active form, you can decide to write the passive way. But using a method like writing the passive way, but using your own words, even though you're writing in the passive way, not just twisting or just turning around, which is what most people do sometimes when they claim they are paraphrasing. They just turn around the words of the writer and claim to have paraphrased. No, use your own words, but still restructure the sentence. Then another thing you can do is to break down the sentences. If the sentence is actually long, then break it down into fragments that you would like when you read it, this was what you understood. So you can break it down into fragments. It doesn't have to be in long chunks like it was in the article that you read. So let's get to a few examples. This is the first example. One thing I would advise is if you're following through with this, after example one, when you see the question for the example two or what we want to paraphrase, try paraphrasing you before you see how I did mine. So now this example one says, obesity is a growing epidemic in the UK among both children and adults, meaning that what I can understand by this is the prevalence of obesity is rising. Before something can become an epidemic, it means in that particular country, it keeps going up. It is a pandemic when it cuts across several countries. But in this case, it is in the UK, so it is an epidemic. How were they able to arrive at that epidemic? That means the prevalence, the number of people who are obese has actually increased. That is what they're saying. And it's among children and adults, meaning everybody. So if I'm to paraphrase this, I will go as in the UK, the prevalence of obesity is currently on the rise. You see, it's among everybody. So I don't need to say among adults. I don't need to say this is in my own words. This is how I see it. There are several ways to write this. You can also say, in the UK, the percentage of people who are obese is currently increasing. So it is left, that's another way to put it. So just make sure you put it in your own words. Now that's example number one. So let's go to the second example. This says the Foresight Obesity Project, which forecasted obesity prevalence among the general population in the UK from current trends, suggests that by 2050, 60% of men and 50% of women will be obese. So you see, I still put the citation there. Where did I get that from? So this is it. So now try doing it yourself before you check out my own answer. Okay? Just try doing it yourself first before you check out my own answer. And so how did I paraphrase this? I did this as by 2050. That was what I was saying earlier, that you don't have to start from the way the original author wrote it. You use your own words. So I wrote, by 2050, 60% and 50% of men and women respectively in the UK will be obese, as predicted by the Foresight Obesity Project. And then I put my reference in there. I cited my reference, which is fine. So another way that I think this can be written is, according to the Foresight Obesity Project, It is predicted that by 2050, then you go on and put in all that. So that is another way to write it, but just make sure that you're writing it in your own words. Now, to my third and final example, which is example three now, I have a review of the literature about ethnic disparity in health metrics in the UK found important differences in high burden diseases and mortality by ethnic group. What does this mean? Basically, what this is saying is there was a literature review that was conducted, and they conducted it based on like ethnicity was plotted against health metrics, and it was realized that for the same high burden disease, the mortality rate differs in various ethnic groups. That is what this sentence is saying. So I'm going to put it in my own words because this sometimes you have to read it over and over before you actually get the meaning. But if I put this in my own words, this is what I have. A literature review conducted in the UK recorded a significant difference in mortality rates between different ethnic groups for the same high burden disease. That was what I understood. And you don't have to use the word high burden disease like they used in the original article, but you can also use it, but you can change it to for the same diseases, for the same chronic conditions, for different things. You can replace it with several things, but I chose to use high burden disease straight still. And I put my reference, which is something you always have to do. If you get something from a source, always put your reference. Guys, I hope I'm making a lot of sense. I hope this makes a lot of sense to you. If you still need more clarification, you can always send me an email. You can always book a consultation. You know that. So, and I hope you have liked and subscribed so far anyway, because there are more gems coming from where this is coming. So guys, this whole paraphrasing thing is an art that can be learned. As in, you just have to take your time, ease out with the copy and paste. Read it, understand it, and then put it in your own way. It's as easy as that. If you need more guidelines, if you need more guides, just reach out to me and then let's see how we can get you sorted. And also, don't worry with the referencing thing, I promise the Mendeley and Zotero that I promise I am going to deliver. I still promise, okay? All right, guys. So I hope that these tips, as in these few tips, will be able to help and guide you as you go along in this journey of paraphrasing, because academic writing is basically about paraphrasing, rewriting, and all, because you need other sources. But the best way to do it is to write it your own way. Like, use your own voice. Use your voice. Don't try to just copy and paste. If you don't understand what the article is talking about, if you can't really get it well, that is why you have email under the author's name. Send an email to the author, tell them to clarify some things for you, and they will gladly respond. At least in more than 75% of them will respond. So use that option, and I'm sure you will definitely benefit. But always make sure to understand the article. I hope this breakdown has been able to help you. Just use the tips, use everything I've given, and I think you should be sorted in the paraphrasing section. And if not, my email is open, okay? All right, guys. So thank you for watching this video this far. I hope you have liked. I hope you have subscribed. And I hope to see you in my next video, okay? So till I see you again, guys, make sure you put a smile on somebody's face. Bye, guys.